It's time, so let's go. Gentlemen, welcome back to the Tiege Hanley Starting a Business, Building a Brand vlog. This one, big number 266. So we're going on a little field trip. It is officially time for me to show you and tell you about the new business, that church I've been working on for literally a year. It's finally time to actually divulge what it is. So here's the plan. We're gonna go over, I'm gonna show you the space, I'm gonna tell you what the business is, and then I thought we'd actually come back to the office and sit down and let me explain why I'm doing this business and kind of like the finances and everything surrounding like this business and why I'm actually pretty excited about it. But gentlemen, it is officially time. You guys must be special or something, because literally I'm showing you guys this first. You are the first ones to actually hear about this this business and what it is and sort of the big reveal. Christian is actually meeting me here tomorrow, and we're gonna film like a proper like big sexy like reveal video for the AlphaM YouTube channel. But I just wanted to actually tell you guys about it first, just because you've had a little bit more to do with the story, you know a little more of the backstory, and honestly, like, you guys are special, and so I just wanted to share it with you guys, and hope you guys, if you're ever in the Marietta area, will decide to come and check it out. Speaking of checking out, before I forget, gentlemen, there is a new piece of original Tiege Hanley content that just dropped. It is all about the benefits of using coconut oil in your hair. Hair? I would like to welcome you to Salon Posta. Let's go in.
How are you?
I'm very welcome. What do you think of the place?
I love it.
Amazing, right?
Yes, very much so.
What's up? All right, gentlemen, so let me give you a quick little tour around, show you what is going on, and then we'll go back to the office and I'll actually, what's up? Hey.
Hello.
You remember Ashley? Anyway, all right, so this is officially like week number two. Last week was our grand, like, kind of soft opening. But as you can see, things are starting to actually happen. Courtney?
Hi. Say
hi. that's all I get?
Yeah.
Come
How
on.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good to see you.
All right, so let me give you a little tour. Okay, so let's go back up front. Sorry. This is so exciting. All right, so when you walk in, you've got the super sexy front desk, right? Then you've got super sexy front desk staff. What's up, Vanessa? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
All right, and so as you can see that like cool like black wall? Behind the front desk, we've got this big giant like 10-foot wall of this like really cool like acrylic smoke. It was just a nice like accent piece to kind of like break up the space and to sort of separate the front from the rest of the salon, all right? You've got product shelves there. You also have product shelves here. And then to the right, you've got sort of like the waiting area, right? We've got coffee, we got tea, we got drinks, we got snacks. And then stylists over here. We've got all the shampoo stations right here, which are nice and sexy. Over here, we have the color bar, all right? This is the area where they like mix all the color to like put on people's hair and make them super beautiful. And then you've got this really cool table here. It's a processing center where the people can just like hang out and like just let their processed color do their thing. Let's go this way. Back down the hall. All right, we did everything black, but the thing, like, I am a huge like bathroom fanatic. Anyway, this is the office over here. It's kind of messy. This is bathroom number one. So I am a huge bathroom like freak, right? And so when I decided to sort of renovate this building, I wanted to make the bathrooms like kind of like old school cool. And so we went with like Carrara marble, like on the floor, the tiles, everything. And then we did like in this bathroom, we did like all the brass hardware. We did these beautiful like pendants, right? Really, really, really classy and beautiful. And then the other bathroom, black bathroom, we got black marble. This one's also like super sexy and just really cool. Across the hall, we have the break room.
Hi.
And we just went with like a subway tile there. Also, we really kind of paid attention to the details with all the beautiful like brass, really cool table there. This is just an area for the stylist to kind of hang out and get away from everything. All right, and so now we've got the other hallway. We've got a laundry room here for all the towels. And then in here is the changing area, right? We've got three different sort of areas where people can get changed into their smocks, hang up their jackets, just really beautiful. We did like the velvet. This has to go over here. Velvet ottoman, beautiful gold mirrors, and I just love like all this like exposed brick and everything. We painted it white like you saw before. We've got two more areas, and then we also over here have a front.
Yo guys, hey, you remember last time when I said stay tuned? Here you go.
Do you guys remember the vlog where Steven was there and we were just talking about business? And do you remember that? Anyway, it's pretty funny. If you go back and watch it, you'll get a few more ideas about this place.
What does the future hold for you and your salon and all that stuff?
You know, maybe eventually have like, you know, maybe another location, a freestanding building, you know, my own parking lot.
It's all about the parking.
Parking, it's all about parking and location.
It's all about parking and location.
Anyway. And here we have a private suite, all right? So if somebody wants to actually come in and book this room, they can have like a little bit more privacy. And it's funny because with COVID, a lot of people are wanting to actually have this room as the place where they actually get their hair done. We've got our own shampoo bowl in here. We also have a nice little like blue velvet couch. But now let's go upstairs. All right, so up here, this is kind of like my favorite area of the salon. It's the mezzanine upstairs, and I'm really, really happy that we built this. The thing that we're planning on doing up here is actually making this like the guys area. We plan on hiring like barbers to be up here so that guys like to get their haircut can come upstairs, have their own little area. We might put like a big like TV on the wall or something of that effect. But we have a few different stations, they're all double-sided, and then we also have this other table. We're gonna put like two mirrors there to have two additional stations. We also have like this really nice little lounge area, two shampoo bowls, and the thing that I love so much about coming up here is that it overlooks the entire space, which is absolutely perfect. So anyway, gentlemen, this is what I've been working on for the past literally a year. But now what I think we should do is actually go back to the office and let me tell you a little bit more about the story and how this whole thing financially works out. So what do you think? Did you guys know it was a salon? Did you think it was a gym? What did you think it was? Anyway, it's going incredibly well, and let's go back to the office. All right, so where to begin and how to not make this story like 45 minutes long. All right, so as you guys know, I have known Steven for many years. In 2013, he was the one who actually gave me the phone number to the lab that I ended up calling and starting Pete and Pedro with. And over the years, and I knew Steven before that, so literally we've known each other for around 10 years. And over the years, I've just kind of been like a silent observer of his business. As you guys know, he used to own Tiege Hanley Posta Salon. About 3 years ago, he and I were talking, and he sort of gave me the impression that he was not 100% happy at his current salon. He was a part owner of Tiege Hanley Posta Salon. And it was him, and then he also had two other partners, another stylist and her husband. And it from what I understand, and there's more to this story that I don't want to divulge because it's none of my business or yours, is you know, it wasn't at the time they started, it was a great situation, but as you know, people grow and as people evolve, it started not being a great situation. And so about 3 years ago, I actually just said to him, I go, you know, if you ever decide you want to, you know, go out on your own, you know, and you need, you know, and want somebody to be like your partner, you know, I'd be happy to do it because A, I knew what salons can do. And I like the industry. And plus I'm rooting for Steven. I think he's an amazing guy. He's an incredibly talented stylist. And so, you know, anytime you can align yourself with smart, you know, people that are great at what they do, you know, I think it's not necessarily the worst decision. And so anyway, 3 years ago, I sort of threw the offer out there. I go, hey, if you're ever interested in doing your own thing, let me know. I might be interested in being an investor or basically like a silent partner of yours. And he said, well, we should talk. And this is like, okay. That was when it sort of was like, okay. Started talking a little bit more about this and about that. And I wasn't pressuring him. Just like, you know what, whatever, just let me know. So then about 2 years ago, he came to me and he's like, were you serious about actually wanting to do this? And I said, yeah. are you ready? Like, let me know. Like, what do we need to do? What does it look like in terms of how much money do we need or how much money do I need to invest in order to, you know, start this business? And so sort of crunched numbers and he told me. And it was, you know, a substantial amount of money. But I was excited. I was like, yeah, you know, this sounds cool. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized that, A, I don't want really like anything to do with it. I don't want to run it. I don't want to operate it. I want like nothing. I just want to basically be able to, you know, use my extra money and you know, diversify myself and let him do his thing. Then I started thinking, I'm like, all right, so how is this going to work? You know, is he going to be running this all by himself? And I don't want, like, I don't have time to do anything with this business. I just want to be a silent investor, partner, and you know, create some type of like passive income. If it's successful, great. If it's not, you know, that's fine as well. But then I started thinking a little bit harder, and I run with a gentleman. His name is Tony. Tony and I went to West Virginia University together at the same time, I should say. And then when we were down here, one day I was doing the Stairmaster at an LA Fitness, you know, probably like 7 or 8 years ago. And he's like, hey, did you go to WVU? I'm like, yeah. And we started talking and became good friends. Really great friends, honestly. And he is somebody that I run with every Sunday. And so we've been running, and he is an incredible salesperson. He has worked for a lot of like tech companies. He also, right now, he works for a really, 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 really big company. But he's a very smart and tech-savvy individual. He is just not, he's never really done like the entrepreneurial thing. But I knew that he might be interested in it. Tony also knows Steven. And I was thinking, all right, let me think about this for a second. How can I do this? Because I knew that Tony wanted to be in business or do something else. I knew that he had some extra money. He's been very successful doing what he does. And so I was like, all right, so what if the three of us joined forces and did this together? And my thinking at the time was Tony would come in and handle a lot of the technical operational stuff that he's really, 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 really good at. The other thing I was thinking is that Tony's wife was starting to look for a job. She was a homemaker. She had, you know, they have three beautiful kids. So I thought, what if Tony's wife, Courtney, who actually you saw in the video, what if she would be one of the managers? We have two managers. We've got Vanessa and then we've got Courtney. That way, not only is Tony paying attention to like all the books and handling all like the stuff that's not fun or sexy that Steven's like no good at, it also puts Tony's wife, who I trust and, you know, who is super smart and sweet and amazing, it would put somebody in the business on a day-to-day, you know, basis basically to look over and oversee my investment. And that's essentially how it happened. Tony put up half the money. I was originally going to put up the other half of the money that we thought that we needed in order to open the salon. And so about 2 years ago, we started looking for a location. And we looked in every strip center, right? And the problem is that at the time, the economy was doing amazing, right? And so all of these retail spaces were full. Like, you know, all the spaces that had like an amazing like anchor store, like a Whole Food, they already had a salon. And that's the thing, like in all of these like retail like strip centers, you typically have something in your lease or a clause that says you can't have somebody else in a competing business. So like one salon, one nail salon, you know, one fitness center, whatever it may be, in these strip centers. And so like every strip center had a hair salon. When we'd find one that didn't, typically what happened was we didn't have enough parking. See, that business requires a ton of parking. And so if you would go into a strip center, right, and say you lease like a 1,500 square foot facility or space, that's typically only going to come with like 6 parking spaces. Well, think about it like this. At Salon Posta, we have 28 stations, which means we need 28 stations for the stylists. We also need assistants. There are basically one assistant per 2 people. So there's another 14 spaces. And then you've got all the other people like the managers and the hourly people that are working, just that are not assisting or doing the work. And so literally, for that salon, we would need like 50 parking spaces just for the staff, right? Not to mention the clients. And so think about this. If you got 28 people that are cutting hair, you need 28 spaces plus the people that are coming in next. So it requires a ton of parking. And so for a year, we looked at all these strip centers. We could never find a space in the desired area that we wanted to be. And so we kept looking. We actually made an offer on this one space, but the landlord, like, they were kind of like an ass, and it ended up not happening. And then last year, around, I guess it was like October, Courtney, Tony's wife, she also like got a real estate license. She said, hey guys, there's this vacant, old, rundown, dilapidated church off Marietta Square. Would you be interested in taking a look? Because prior to that, when Tony, Stephen, and I, we would meet like once a month to sort of go over things and talk about what we needed to talk about. And I said to the guys, I go, look, we are having like zero luck finding a retail space that we can move into. I said, you know, I like real estate. And so if we find a space that's, you know, we think in a good location that would be amazing, I would be open to actually buying it and then renting the space to the salon in order to open or run its business. A few weeks later, Courtney, who is Tony's wife, also got a real estate license in the past, like, you know, year, was like, hey, there's an old, dilapidated, rundown church right off of Marietta Square. Are you interested in checking it out? I'm like, off the square? That old rundown building? I'm like, all right. So we met over there, and it was, as you guys saw in some of the previous videos, it was an absolute disaster. But because it's in Marietta, my city that I love, absolutely love, go over there and the three of us take a look, and it was one of those things where we all kind of walked in and we knew that it was going to take, or I knew that it was going to take just an ungodly amount of work, effort, and love, not to mention money, in order to fix that place up. But that day, I literally said to Courtney, after we kind of talked, I said, you want to do this? Because the other upside to that building is that it has, or it came with, a bunch of parking spaces in the back. Now, it wasn't enough parking, and so what we ended up doing was leasing some additional spaces around, like, the area. There are some, like, public parking areas really close, and so we've leased a bunch of these spaces for, like, our staff to actually park, like, off-site, walk to this facility, leave the parking spaces, and back for our clients. Anyway, so that day that we walked in, I said to Courtney, I said, okay, I said, you guys are serious, let's do this. And so we made an offer, and you know, they ended up, you know, countering. I countered back, ended up accepting, and the rest is kind of history. Speaking of history, before I actually closed on the building, we had like a 90-day due diligence because there's a lot of issues with that building, and I wanted to make sure that I wasn't walking into like a sewer toxic waste dump. And so I ended up going a few times to the historic board, meeting with them to talk about what we wanted to do to get approval. I had a phase one environmental study done on the building, which exposed the fact that there was some lead paint. And so I ended up, you know, going back and like reworking the deal with the person that was selling it to get a little bit lower cost, and all that to say, bought the building. And for the past year, we have been in the process of doing what we needed to do. And so the way that it works, I am the owner of the building, the property. I also purchased all of the, everything pretty much in the salon. So I own like the stations, like the front, like I basically built a salon and I own that. And for that, I get paid rent every single month. And I also have a percentage ownership in the salon business. And so, you know, once a year we will pay, take like a profit distribution, the owners, the three owners, Tony, Stephen, and myself. And that's kind of that. And I am so incredibly thankful that the project is finished on my end. And it's just been amazing. It has been absolutely better than I dreamed in terms of the finished product. Also the reception from, you know, all the people coming in. And the other thing that really, and if I'm being completely honest with you, because that's kind of my thing, part of the other reason why I was excited to do it was because of where it was and the fact that this is my like small town that I love. And that building has been an eyesore for the community for the past 30 years it's been vacant. And so it was my ability, or it was my way of sort of, I don't know, sort of like giving my little community like a big hug, you know, and fixing up this old space, and it's really amazing, and I couldn't be happier. And I just wanted to show you and talk to you guys about it and tell you kind of the back end story of how this all came to be. But a salon is one of those businesses that I've always sort of had my eye on. I didn't want to run it. I don't want to do anything with it. I love the business. And the other thing about salons, which may shock you, is they can absolutely crush it in terms of like revenue. If it's a high-end salon, you know, the average ticket price is around like $150 per person that comes in there. You have like, think about that. You have 28 people or 20, say you have 20 stylists. You know, they're doing like 10, 11, 12 people a day. You know, it starts to really be amazing. And the other cool thing about a salon is that the only cost is labor and like $5, $6 worth of like hair color or product. So it's a very profitable service business. The other upside is that it is almost, I don't want to say recession proof. It is not COVID proof or you know, shutdown proof, because that's one thing that Stephen had happen at his other salon was they ended up having to shut down, you know. But barring shutting down and being forced to shut down, salons are typically a pretty recession-proof business. Women are crazy about their hair, and they, unlike guys, aren't gonna just like maybe like do it themselves or color it themselves. And once they start going gray, it's like every 2 weeks they're in there getting a root touch-up or some type of service. Now, in terms of recession, you know, the thing that Steven saw last time when the economy kind of tanked, they had the same amount or volume of business, but instead of people having like a few different services or getting like three colors in their hair, they would cut back. But it still did incredibly well. And it's amazing. And it's a great business. And I am incredibly thrilled to do it. Like I said, I'm very excited. And I think that once you guys see like the big sexy video that Christian and I put together, we'll be hopefully releasing it in the next like week, maybe a little longer. I think it's going to be just super sick. And you guys are definitely going to dig it. I'm going to link down below to the website. If you guys are ever in the Marietta area and want to come, make sure to give a call or schedule one online, an appointment. It's salonposta.com. But anyway, guys, I just wanted to take you there first, honestly, because it's a business, because that's what we've been talking about, and I've brought you there really a few times, and I just thought it was appropriate to share the experience with you first before, you know, I shared it with everybody else. But I just want to say thank you. Thank you for paying attention. Thank you for following along. Anyway, guys, that is where I'm going to wrap this long, winding, meandering story up. You know, basically, the bottom line is this. You know, I had a friend who I believe in, who I've known for years, who wanted to do his own thing, and I'm lucky enough to be a part of it and part of his story, and he's gonna be part of mine. And Tony is along for the ride. He's kind of like back end, like behind the scenes, but it's just great to be able to do this with friends. I trust both of them, you know, with everything, and it's just really cool. It's really cool to see something come to life. And I hope that if you're ever in the Marietta area, you can come and check out the space. Just come on by and or make an appointment and have your hair did. We are currently working on hiring barbers for upstairs to handle men. Until then, some of the stylists do men's cuts. Steven does mine, of course. Anyway, guys, I just cannot wait for you guys to come see it if you're ever in the area. The website is Salon Posta. I'll link to it down below. Until next time, gentlemen, we love you more than our double monk strap shoes. And Merry Christmas.